Good morning students, I am Pavan, your science master. Today I would like to speak to 7th standard students. Students, in the previous class we have talked about second lesson, acids and bases. In the lesson we have talked about the nature of the substances can be classified based on their tastes, okay, and the nature like acidic or basic that we have discussed in the previous class, and also we made list of the tastes of different substances. I have given you a project work to make the list of the foods that are sweet in taste and sour in taste, bitter in taste, salt in taste, spicy in taste. Students, I hope you have done that, and if you have done that, that's well and good. And also we have talked about the substances responsible for the taste of the food materials. You know, different food materials have different tastes because of some of the substances present in them. Some substances are responsible for the taste of those food items. In the first lesson, food components, the substances, food substances are responsible for body building and keeping us healthy. Here, some substances are responsible for the taste of the foods. Okay, and here we have also discussed about the nature, like, you know, to identify the nature like acidic or basic, there are some indicators. So what is indicator? Indicator definition is like this. Indicator means a substance indicates a change in color when that reacts with other substances which are acidic or basic in nature. Students, the indicator that changes its color when that is reacted with other substances that are acidic or basic in nature. See, the indicator indicates the change in color, but it's not a guaranteed change. The change may occur, the change may not occur. That means the change may happen, the change may not happen. So if change happens, you can understand the substance may be acidic or basic. If there is no change at all, that's a neutral substance. What might be that? That's a neutral substance. Neutral substance. Neutral in the sense, the substance that's neither acidic nor basic. Okay, got the point? And let us talk about different types of indicators. The indicators indicators are of two types. One is natural and artificial. See, the meaning in this word itself you can understand. Natural, they are not man-made, they are available in the nature. Examples for natural indicators are like turmeric and petals of hibiscus and petals of oleander. Oleander, hibiscus in our local language it is called as mandara. Oleander in our local language it is called as ganneru. And petals of hibiscus and petals of oleander. And mango leaves. Mango leaves and beetroot and etc. There are so many indicators, natural indicators present, but these are few of them. These are few of them. Okay, children, but how you have to use these things as indicators, that is the important thing. Here, turmeric, you have to add some water to turmeric and make it into paste. Okay. And hibiscus and oleander petals are, you know, the petals in the sense part of flower, right? Yeah, petals are collected and they are crushed, and then after you crush these petals, you will find a liquid part of the petals, right? That is the extraction of petals. Extraction of the petals. And you have to use that extraction as indicator. And mango leaves also same like that. You have to crush them. You have to crush them. After you crush them, you will get a liquid part of these leaves, and then that is used as indicator. And beetroot also same like that, you know. So these indicators are used as these are the things used as indicators. These are natural indicators. But how do you identify, how do you identify the nature of the substances? So they change in their color. They are there, you can notice some change in their color when they are treated with acids or bases, or acidic substances or basic substances. Like this, you can identify the nature of the substances using these natural indicators. And as far as this artificial indicators concerned, here you can say, for example, litmus paper and phenolphthalein and methyl orange. These are artificial or chemical indicators. So these, you know, these are used in industrial level, that you will understand in detail in your higher classes, but you have a basic information about these things. I will teach about that in the coming class. Okay, that's about this. And indicators are like this, you know. What are the indicators? Now you can identify indicators are of two types: natural indicators, artificial indicators. And the natural indicators examples are turmeric, hibiscus, oleander, and mango leaves, beetroot. Especially hibiscus and oleander, flower petals are collected and that extracted. That extraction is used as, you know, indicator. Okay, like this you can find the nature of the substances using these indicators, children. Okay. This is for today, students, and thank you for listening. Thank you, one and all. And you please try to understand what are natural indicators and what are artificial indicators. You just remember and write it in your notes very clearly and present it in our WhatsApp group.